There's balance for everyone.
Even a call girl.
Even a call girl.
What is going on in here? Did y'all have sex in there?
It's no heaven for me.
He married a prostitute. And he has brought shame to this church.
Oh, hell no. Okay,
watch
all
out.
Right.
Watch out.
That is just a little taste of Sinners Wanted in theaters right now. Ladies and gentlemen, we have the Jenkins Brothers in the building.
Bravo.
What's up?
Good morning, Joshua, Jimmy. Man, thank you guys so much for being here.
Thank you for having us.
How about that trailer?
Juicy, right?
It's a suspense. Made me say, how do I get a ticket? You guys are a hot topic. You know, the weekend is a great time to go to the movies. And Sinners Wanted, so many people have been talking about it. Like, the word of mouth in this area, in Prince George's County as in particular, it has spread and it's getting bigger and bigger and bigger. So it was important for us to bring you guys on and just let more people know about this movie, Sinners Wanted. First and foremost, you guys are a part of such an a pivotal, very important church.
Yes.
In Prince George's County. I actually live behind it.
Okay.
Yeah, so it's like on Sundays, it's very difficult to get off of Church Road. Okay?
Right.
But First Baptist Church in Glen Arden. Shout out to Pastor Jenkins over there.
Yes.
Lady
Pop,
Jenkins.
Dad, and mom.
Yes.
Yeah, mom and dad.
And so you guys, you know, you've grown up in this church culture.
Yeah.
And so when I saw Sinners Wanted and I saw the trailer, I was just like, oh, okay.
Hit you in your chest. Hold on now.
Can we talk about it? So Jimmy and Josh, thank you again for being here. Let's talk about Sinners Wanted and how you all put it together. This is not your first project. Of course, you've been doing over 15 projects together collectively, right?
Yeah.
Yes. Yep.
So
yes.
How did we get to Sinners Wanted? This right here is probably, I guess, is this the biggest to date?
Yes.
Okay.
Well, I started in theater.
Okay.
I went to Bowie State University.
Now, say, which one are you?
I'm Josh.
Yeah, okay.
This is Josh. Yes, this is Josh.
Right,
the older brother, even though I don't look like it. But
you're the older one? Oh,
yes,
okay.
I'm the older brother. Right, okay. Exactly.
Didn't think that.
Yeah, I know.
Okay.
It's the muscles that I got. He ain't got no muscles. That's why you ain't know.
That's the difference.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I started in theater about 15 years ago, and I didn't start really. I went to school for film, and I did a minor in theater, but I didn't really start getting into film until my little brother convinced me to do film. I was doing plays at the church, or whatever the case may be. I was doing plays, he was doing plays, and he was like, bro, we need to do this movie.
Mm.
And he convinced me to take this journey with him. We did a play first before we did the movie, but he really convinced me to say, you know, we can reach more people if we do film.
Versus theater. And so Jimmy, what made you want to get into the film side of things?
Like I said, I copied everything my brother did growing up, and I always just wanted to, like, he played football, he played basketball, I did everything he did, and I wanted just to be better than him in everything.
Well,
from Madden to, like, I don't care what it is, checkers or just playing hopscotch or whatever, I wanted to beat him.
Yeah.
So I copied everything he did, and he started writing plays, and so I started writing plays. I said, how can I take it to the next level? I said, well, I gotta do movies. So in college, I was actually playing college football.
Hmm.
I had some money to pay for my education, and I decided to stop playing football, forego the sponsorship money to start my company at 19. My parents thought I was crazy.
Dope.
Everybody thought I was crazy. I did it. I even ended up working with BET and Tyler Perry. I left both those jobs too to do this full time. And I made my first movie at 21.
Hmm.
Got called to LA to make another movie for somebody else at 23, got criticized at 22, got criticized really bad by the LA Times, learned a lot from it.
Mm.
Then I made short films, and then we came together, and then we made this big film.
So it's been a journey.
Oh, man, silly journey. Like, we went through a lot, like.
Yeah, to get to this point.
Yeah.
So what was the inspiration behind Sinners Wanted? Like, how did this plot come to you? Is this based on a true story?
Yeah, it's a biblical story.
It's a Bible story.
It's a Bible story.
Oh, it's a Bible story.
So so it's like the modern
day
version of.
People our age don't understand the Bible. Like, if you tell somebody, go open up the book of Hosea and they read it, they're like, okay,
what
did I
just
read?
Yeah, what is this?
Wow. So this is an actual.
It's a biblical story.
Well, because I got the Holy Bible
now.
Which book now? I got the Holy Bible on my phone.
Go to Hosea 3:1.
We go.
All right.
Yeah.
When you get there, say amen.
Turn to the book. Amen.
Okay, so in the book of Hosea 3:1, What would tell us about the story?
So it's about a man of God who God tells to go marry a harlot, which is a prostitute, a woman of the of sin, woman of the nightlife.
Okay.
Because God wanted to show Israel, his people, how much he loved them, right?
Wow.
So what happens is this pastor meets, finds this prostitute, and he loves her. He loves her unconditionally. It's a story about unconditional love. Just like God loves us, no matter what you do, no matter where you've been.
Talk about it.
He loves you. He wants you. He's always going to love you. And that's what it's about. No, it's nothing you can do to stop God from loving you. That's really what it's about.
Wow. And so I guess he gets scrutinized, the pastor.
Absolutely.
Because she's a prostitute that he's married.
And me and my brother, we grew up in church, you know. We have a great church, you know. We've been blessed to have a great church, but we've seen church culture. We've seen the negative side of church.
Mm-hmm.
We've seen the positive side of church. And this was a way to bring things to life, to, you know, hold churches accountable, you know, hold people accountable, just to say, hey, just because the church hurts you or does something to you one time or two times, don't stop going back. You don't stop going to the grocery store when you get treated. But you might find another grocery store, but you need groceries.
Y'all don't stop going to Chick-fil-A.
You don't start going to Chick-fil-A.
Your fries not hot.
Exactly. So it's to show both sides. God's love. And then, you know, some things that the church has messed up on. But there are great churches out here, you know. So it's that's what it's about.
No, I think you guys have a great point. We had Keith Battle in here about a week ago.
The big bro.
Yeah.
Shout out Zion Church.
Yes, and we were kind of talking about just the idea of forgiveness when a pastor comes before his congregation and says, you know, I've done this or I've done that, and would you stay? So we've got the great debate coming up next.